Well, I think of my work as meta-realist, meta-realism as opposed to classical materialism. But I do come from materialist roots, the materialist branch of post-structuralism, people like Foucault and Deleuze and Irigaray, who talk about matter as being essentially embodiment, the bodies that we inhabit. And these bodies need to be perceived not in a dualistic mind-body opposition, but as self-organizing whole things. So that tradition of post-structuralism is crucial because that's my origins, that's my source of inspiration. There are, of course, other factors involved in this materiality, and that is the role that bodily materialism, but also material location, space, counter-history, and genealogies play in the radical epistemologies and the marginal discourses that have also been very important to my work, feminism essentially, but post-colonialism, race theory, and some sort of environmentalism. All of these kind of discourses and areas of research have absolutely transcended the dualism mind-body, and they really look at the materiality of beings as a continuum. They look at what Donna Haraway calls the material semiotic continuum. They look at practices of existence and practices of representation as running alongside each other. I would add to that that meta-realism has become particularly important over the last 20 so years because of the great advances in science and technology. To say that we live in an era where life is the dominant concept would be to say nothing. What has happened around the life sciences, the new understanding of our the biochemistry of our bodies, of evolutionary theories, of the neural structure of our entire sensorial apparatus, and the new biogenetics, all of these new sciences make the materiality of the body perfectly understandable. And they have turned matter into something that is capable of self-organizing, autopoietic, we would say. And I find this type of new scientific development about the materiality of life perfectly compatible with the monistic philosophies of my beloved Deleuze, Guattari, and in some moments also of Irigaray, that just look at matter as intelligent, dynamic, organizing system with its own temporality, its own codes, and certainly, obviously, related to what we call the mind. But that mind is not transcendental in relationship to the materiality of the body. It's absolutely in the body. So we talk about the embodiment of mind and the embrainment of the body. They really do work together. And I think my beloved political scientific discourses from the margins, feminism essentially, are very well equipped to deal with this. Whether the humanities as a whole can cope with the challenge of meta-realism, however, is a real question. And I think this great turn to under-materiality may create a few difficulties for the traditional humanities, those of the humanities that still haven't really accepted the crisis of humanism, let alone, to quote Foucault, the death of men. So I see two difficulties in the humanities relationship to materialism. One is the methodological nationalism that makes so much research in the humanities very parochial, very nation-bound. I'm sure you can get any amount of money if you do a research project that actually is good for Swiss history or for the Swiss national identity or for the Swiss economy. And so the methodological nationalism defeats the planetary time frame of so many of the problems that we're looking at today, or the generic time frame, if it is true that we are redefining the boundaries of what counts as the human. So methodological nationalism doesn't really help. And the other problem is the entrenched anthropocentrism of the humanities. And they really are, our beloved disciplines assume the centrality of man, the centrality of the human. So can they deal with the challenge of meta-realism, the challenge of transversal nature-culture continuums? That's a really good question, and I have my doubts about this. So my hope is that the humanities do learn from feminism, from race theory, from post-colonialism on the one hand, and that they develop a new relationship to the sciences on the other in order to be able to cope with the challenges of the third millennium. I think we need post-human humanities in order to deal with the challenges of today. And as a meta-realist, I hope to do my best, bring a small contribution to what I consider a great challenge for today.